Hello guys, welcome to my class. This is class number 10 on your topic of integration. In this class, I will cover a subtopic of integration of function relating to inverse of trigonometry. I'm Engineer Goodlucky. You can contact me through my email goodlucky.daudk@gmail.com, and I am from Tanzania. Okay. Integration of basic function relating to inverse of trigonometry. Okay, consider the following examples. Example number one. Integrate negative dx. Negative dx over square root of 1 minus x square. In order to integrate this function, we must remember what function when you differentiate gives this result. This is cos inverse of x. So, when we differentiate cos inverse of x, we get negative 1 over square root of 1 minus x square. So, when we integrate negative dx over square root of 1 minus x square, we get cos inverse of x plus c. Okay, example number 2 is integral of dx over square root of 1 minus x square. So we must remember what function when you differentiate gives the result. This function is sine inverse of x. When you differentiate sine inverse of x, we get 1 over square root of 1 minus x square. So the integral of dx over square root of 1 minus x square, we get sine inverse of x plus c. Okay, example number 3 is integral of dx over x times under root of x square minus 1. So, we must remember which function when we differentiate give 1 over x times the square root of x square minus 1. And this is sec inverse of x. So when I integrate dx over x times the square root of x square minus 1, I get sec inverse of x plus constant. So let's look on example number 4. Integral of negative dx over x times the square root of x square minus 1. So we must remember which function when we differentiate give us the result of negative 1 over x times the square root of x square minus 1. This is the cosec inverse. So when I integrate integral of negative dx over x times the square root of x square minus 1, I get e cosec inverse of x plus a constant c. So when I integrate dx over 1 plus x square, I must remember which function when I differentiate gives this result, 1 over 1 plus x square, which is tan inverse of x. So when I integrate this function, I get an inverse of x plus c. As well, when I integrate negative dx over 1 plus x square, I must remember which function when I differentiate gives this result of negative 1 over 1 plus x square is cot inverse of x. So when I integrate this function, I get cot inverse of x plus a constant. These all six are basic integral for a function that related to inverse of trigonometry. So any function of the form like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 must hold the result of inverse of trigonometry. Note, in place of 1 or of x square can be as a constant. So you can get equation with different variables like this. You must do as you must do like what I will show you in the next examples. Okay, let's consider some example. How to solve this? How to solve this integral of 9 dx over 2 plus x square? In this example, we see there is a constant 9, 2, and here we have x square. This has a form of inverse of tan. So the result of this function is tan inverse of some value. So how we know about tan inverse of that value? This function results to tan inverse, all of you know, but tan inverse of what value? Okay, let's write this integral in a standard form. Make sure it look like the basic function of tan inverse of x, which is this one. The integral of this one is tan inverse of x. The integral of this one is tan inverse of a certain angle, which is unknown. Okay, 9 and 2 are constant. I factor 9 out of the integral sign as well as 2. So what I have is this one. Integral of 9 dx over 2 out of this expression we have 1 plus bracket x over under root of 2 bracket square bracket, which is equal to 9 over 2 integral of dx over 1 plus x over under root of 2 bracket square. So this look like this, except in a place of x we have x over under root of 2. So we let tan of any angle, let's say y, is equal to this value x over under root of 2. This is technique. So when I differentiate with respect to x, I get this one. So x square of y dy is equal to the x over under root of 2. Okay. 9 over 2 is out of integral. We have the x over 1 plus x over root of 2 square bracket. But tan of y is equal to x over under root of 2, and dx is equal to under root of 2 when I differentiate, as I show here. We have dx under root of 2 come to this side. We have dx is equal to under root of 2 x square of y dy. So in a place of dx, we put under root of 2 x square of y dy. And therefore, we have under root of 2 x square of y dy over 1 plus x over under root of 2 is tan of y. So we have tan of y square. Okay, 1 plus tan square of y is equal to sec square of y. So sec square of y and 1 plus tan square of y cancel. We have this result, 9 over 2 under root of 2 dy is equal to 9 under root of 2 over 2 times y dy. Integral of dy, you know, is y. So 9 over 2, 9 times the under root of 2 over 2, y plus constant. So what is y? Y is the inverse of x over under root of 2. So we have 9.